These are two American theatrical posters, posters to advertise theater. From the turn of the century, this one, Peck's Bad Boy, featuring Dot Karroll, the best impersonator of boy characters in America, printed by Enterprise Litho, and this one printed by Ackerman Quigley for Uncle Tom's Cabin. These posters were in rough condition, and we gave them a poster fix. Watch. This gets wet, this will come off. He had a lovely, beautiful gal, 'twas a Louisiana belle. In case you don't know, linen backing is a fantastic process for mounting your poster, especially an old poster which is in poor condition or which is very brittle and you want to make it stronger and presentable. Or if the poster is in bad condition and needs to have a lot of restoration, linen backing is an archival mounting process where we take your poster and affix it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. This helps to enhance the value, strength, and display of the poster. It makes your poster great again. There's not much I can say about Dot Karroll. As far as I know, she was an actress. I think she did one movie, one sound movie in the 30s. Apparently, she was an impersonator of male characters. And it's an intriguing poster. I think it would have a lot of appeal for some people. It's certainly a beautifully done portrait with great lithography.
I wonder if she was a dyke.
A little bit about the book, Uncle Tom's Cabin, written by Harriet Beecher Stowe from Connecticut. Uncle Tom's Cabin, or Life Among the Lowly, is an anti-slavery novel by the American author Harriet Beecher Stowe, published in 1852. The novel had a profound effect on attitudes toward African Americans and slavery in the U.S., and is said to have, quote, helped lay the groundwork for the Civil War, unquote. Stowe, a Connecticut-born teacher at the Hartford Female Seminary, and an active abolitionist, featured the character of Uncle Tom, a long-suffering black slave around whom the stories of other characters revolve. The sentimental novel depicts the reality of slavery while also asserting that Christian love can overcome something as destructive as enslavement of fellow human beings. Uncle Tom's Cabin was the best-selling novel of the 19th century and the second best-selling book of that century, following the Bible. It is credited with helping fuel the abolitionist cause in the 1850s. In the first year after it was published, 300,000 copies of the book were sold in the United States, 1 million copies in Great Britain. In 1855, 3 years after it was published, it was called the most popular novel of our day. The impact attributed to the book is great, reinforced by a story that when Abraham Lincoln met Stowe at the start of the Civil War, Lincoln declared, quote, "So this is the little lady who started this great war," unquote. The quote is apocryphal. It did not appear in print until 1896, and it has been argued that, quote, the long-term durability of Lincoln's greeting as an anecdote in literary studies and Stowe scholarship can perhaps be explained in part by the desire among many contemporary intellectuals to affirm the role of literature as an agent of social change. In other words, Lincoln probably didn't really say that. The book and the plays it inspired helped popularize a number of stereotypes about black people. These include the affectionate dark-skinned mammy, the pickaninny stereotype of black children, and the Uncle Tom, or dutiful, long-suffering servant, faithful to his white master or mistress.
Done.
Very good. We're gonna let these posters dry for a few days before we trim them down. In this story, Simon Legree is a slave owner from the North who transplants to Louisiana. His depiction is also a stereotype. It's a definitely negative image that would be predicated by progressive abolitionists in the North to depict the slave owners as evil, whipping, nasty people. And I'm not disputing that some of that activity happened, but the relationship between masters and slaves in the Old South is much more detailed, nuanced, and complicated than that. But he's a stereotype that serves the abolitionist cause.
Never dreary if the darkie never groans. The lady's never weary with the rattle of the bones. Then come again, Susanna, by the gaslight of the moon. We'll tum the old piano when the banjo's out of tune. Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long? Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long? Oh, never count the bubbles while there's water in the spring. The darkie have no troubles while he's got his song to sing. The beauties of creation will never lose their charm while I roam the old plantation with my true love on my arm. Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long? Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long? In the morning on a lovely summer day, my massa send me warning he'd like to hear me play. On the banjo tapping I came with dulcet strain. Massa fallin' appin', he'll never wake again. Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long? Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long? My love, I have to leave you while the river's running high. But I never can deceive you, so don't you wipe your eye. I'm going to make some money, but I'll come another day. I'll come again, my honey, if I have to work my way. Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long? Ring, ring the banjo, I like that good old song. Come again, my true love, oh, where you been so long?
As you can see, these posters have been given a new lease on life through PosterFix. PosterFix helps your posters be stable again, neutralizes the acids. PosterFix helps your posters be strong again. PosterFix helps your posters be displayable again. And finally, PosterFix makes your posters great again.